with the South Carolina coroner to identify the victims of the shooting that happened in Charleston. The Justice Department and the FBI opening up a hate crime investigation into the massacre in South Carolina last night. Officials saying that the suspect, Dylann Roof, sat in a prayer meeting at the historic Black College in Charleston, or the Black Church, I should say, for an hour before opening fire. Nine people killed at the Emmanuel AME Church. And just a short time ago, Roof arrested at a traffic stop in North Carolina, and his car now in evidence. So let's bring in Keith Sullivan. He's a criminal defense attorney. So I'm sure that you've been watching these developments throughout the day, and this is being called a hate crime. So what does that mean for this case and the charges involved?
This is just an absolutely horrific and horrendous act of violence, and we'll never fully understand why certain people will lower themselves to this level of inhumanity. What's really interesting here, that this crime took place in South Carolina, and South Carolina is one of the few states in the country that does not have a hate crime bias crime on the books. So they would charge him with just regular murder. However, what the hate crime normally does is it enhances the penalty. And what's interesting here is South Carolina, although they don't have a hate crime statute, they do have the death penalty. So there's no further enhancement. So there's nothing lost by not having the hate crime.
What about whether the federal authorities handle this case or state authorities?
So if the feds get involved, which it looks like they're clearly intend on getting involved, or at least jointly working on the investigation, and certainly that's probably the proper way to go at this point, because he's a North Carolina resident, traveled across state lines to South Carolina, and then traveled back to North Carolina where he was arrested. So he'll ultimately be extradited back to South Carolina.
I think he was actually from Lexington, South Carolina. So he was a South Carolina resident.
Okay.
But he was picked up in Shelby, North Carolina.
In North Carolina. Okay.
Yeah.
That's where the crossing state lines comes into in the escape. If the feds prosecute, which is very likely here, they will have to prove that he intended on targeting these individuals because of their race. Mm-hmm. And that's an added element of the case, which you won't have in the South Carolina prosecution. They just have to prove the murder, which will be fairly, I think, easy to do in this under these circumstances. Mm-hmm. There's eyewitnesses to the murder. People survived.
Absolutely. And by some reports, he actually wanted some people to survive so they could go out and say what had happened.
So they go out and tell the story. I mean, it's just, it's hard to wrap your mind around.
What about the fact that he sat there, reportedly, in this prayer service for an hour before he took any action?
It's so interesting. And just moments ago, you had the criminalist on and you know, talked about terrorism, whether this was an act of terrorism. And what's interesting, from a legal standpoint, the word terrorism has never fully been defined. There's about 100 different definitions out there. The UN has one definition. What's common to all of the various definitions is that it's a criminal act of violence intended to inflict fear. And that's exactly what he did. Why he sat there for that hour, is it to further create fear that they could be sitting amongst someone who then later, you know, becomes their murderer? Mm-hmm. Well, we may never know. Maybe he was trying to steel himself and gain the courage. You know, we just don't know. Not that I don't mean courage in the sense that it takes strength, but, you know, the nerve, I should say, to do it, or the cowardice, really.
Cowardice.
To get to that point and actually pull the trigger.
Definitely.
Real, depraved human being.
So they've taken his car into custody at this point, no doubt searching through it. They've talked
forensics,
to many of his family
line.
Members already. They're already on top of it. What will be the evidence that they need?
Well, I think the best evidence is the murder weapon. Hopefully that may be in the car. I mean, he may confess to them
and
where
the
it's located.
Yeah.
And then secondly, those witnesses.
Yeah.
I think there's a young girl, and then there's the older woman who was let go. The young girl played dead. She played possum.
5-year-old.
I think at her grandmother or aunt's direction, who unfortunately is dead. So there'll be eyewitnesses to this, and it's just going to be chilling testimony. If it ever gets there, he may just take a plea deal, because he will be facing the death penalty if he's prosecuted in
regardless.
South Carolina. Regardless.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
Your insight. We'll continue to follow it. And another